Hi, my name is Dr. Julian Clifton. I'm the Head of Department of Geography and Planning, and I'm here to talk to you about the Environmental Geography and Planning major. I'll be introducing you to the Department of Geography and Planning at UWA, outlining the range of majors that we offer, and then we'll look in detail at the Environmental Geography and Planning major. We'll look at the units, we'll look at the content, and we'll identify how this can give you new and exciting career pathways following graduation. Geography and Planning at UWA has a long history. We were established back in 1964, and in the most recent national assessment of research excellence, we achieved the highest possible rating of well above world standard in human geography, and we were one of only two departments in the whole of Australia to achieve that ranking, and we received the very high ranking of above world standard in physical geography. Our teaching and research in geography cuts across key areas, as we'll see, all of which have high employment potential. And within the department, we pride ourselves on having a strong and active student society. And as a department, we maintain close links both with schools in terms of supplying our students and employers to ensure that the graduates that we work with have the necessary workplace skills. We have three undergraduate majors in the department: the BSc Geography, the BA Human Geography and Planning, and the Bachelor's of Environmental Design in Environmental Geography and Planning. I'll be talking about the latter one now, but you can see other videos relating to the other two majors on the online Open Day website. So in Environmental Geography and Planning, you'll learn about planning for sustainability. Sustainability is a key objective in modern society, and it's all about reconciling the impacts of economic development with the consequences on the natural environment and ensuring that as many people as possible benefit from the economic development that we're experiencing. With regards to our major, we're interested in sustainability of landscapes, cities, and communities. So you'll be learning in this major how to plan and create livable communities, places where everyone has sufficient and adequate access to things like recreational facilities, to transport facilities, to shopping, everything that makes modern urban life enjoyable and rewarding. So we'll be looking in our units at creating these sustainable, livable communities. We'll be looking at how to design landscapes, particularly recreational landscapes, which reflect the environmental objectives within cities. One of the consequences of climate change is the increased air temperatures that we will find in cities as we progress through the coming decades, primarily due to the fact that concrete and similar surfaces like that reflect heat rather than absorb it. So anywhere in urban environments, you'll often find air temperatures up to maybe 7 or even 10 degrees Celsius higher than surrounding rural areas. So this stress associated with the urban heat island effect, this is something we can combat if we plan and create more green spaces, green buildings for cities into the future. And we'll be also very interested in promoting your skills and techniques in things like geographic information systems, or GIS, and remote sensing, which are key essential elements in the modern workplace. This demonstrates and outlines the program of study that you will follow in this major, from levels 1 through to level 2 and level 3. And each of those shapes there are units that you will, core units, sorry, that you will study in this major. So at level 1, we have units which look at urbanization and sustainability, the sort of thing I was just talking about, and an introduction to urban design, principles of urban design, taught by the School of Urban Design. At level 2, we have two units from our colleagues in landscape architecture, training you in techniques and skills in designing and creating sustainable landscapes involving, as I've mentioned earlier, green landscapes in particular. At level 2, you also get a unit which introduces you to GIS, Jog 2201 there, and a fieldwork unit which takes you around often the Perth metro area and also further afield. And the emphasis here is on understanding how people have used and transformed landscapes in the urban and regional environment. Moving to level three, we have another fieldwork unit, which I'll come back to in a minute. We have a unit which introduces you to advanced techniques in urban planning and design, building upon those units at level one. We also have an advanced GIS and remote sensing unit, and a unit which introduces you to principles and practice in environmental policy and planning. The fieldwork unit there at level three builds upon our level two fieldwork unit through designing, through giving you the responsibility to design, instigate, and complete a project looking at one instance of human modification and use of urban landscapes or natural landscapes. Remember, at UWA, you can combine your first major with your choice of second major. So you could combine this major with, for example, the BSc Geography, the BA Landscape Architecture, or the BSc Environmental Management, just to name a few. Alternatively, instead of choosing a second major, you can complete the units that you are required to study through selecting units from any other major across the university. In this Environmental Geography and Planning major, you'll develop a range of highly important and valued workplace skills. You'll be trained in issues relating to leadership, project design, and project management, primarily through the fieldwork units that I've mentioned, but also through assessment in other units that you'll study as part of the core within this major. Throughout, you'll be trained in methods of data collection, data manipulation, data analysis, and reporting. It can be quantitative data, it could be remotely sensed data. Skills in how to collect and report upon data are essential skills in the workplace, whichever career pathway you're choosing. And you'll also be trained and assessed regularly throughout each of the 3 years in professional report writing. Could be through producing consultancy reports, policy briefs, environmental impact assessment statements. All of these are professional skills which employers require. And these form part of the assessment as you go through each of the units. Following graduation, you'll have a range of very exciting, rewarding, and diverse career pathways. And these are not careers which are cyclical. These are not careers which disappear in periods of economic recession, such as we're going through now. These are in constant demand by employers, both in the public and the private sector. You could be interested in developing a career, for example, environmental consultancy, working as an independent freelance consultant for environmental organisations, whether they be public or government or in the private sector. You could develop a career in planning, mainly in the public sector, but also in the private sector, where you could be looking at planning issues in urban, regional and natural areas. Or you could be interested in developing a career, again, in private or public sector, in environmental, social and economic policy development, producing policy briefs to guide decision making in these key areas. If you want more information, feel free to contact myself, Dr. Julian Clifton, in the Department of Geography and Planning, or Professor Kate Hislop, who is head of the School of Urban Design. Alternatively, look for Environmental Geography and Planning in the UWA handbook. And I hope this has been of interest to you and that you enjoy the rest of our online open day. Thank you very much.